It just sounds like I've babbled. I'm sorry. Let's start again. Hello, my gorgeous friends. Summer holidays over, kids are back at school, and spending quality time with my children has prompted me to press stop or reset and reevaluate everything, come back with a more deep and a meaningful way of living. And I've picked up a couple of strategies that's helping me to get more out of my daily activities and live life to the fullest. So, first one is, the best way to do that is think of a friend. We're very good at listening to our friend when they need us. When they're feeling sad, we try and make them happy. When they're feeling down, we try and lift them up. We compliment our friends. Do that for yourself. Be kind to yourself and speak kindly about yourself, because there's so many things happening in the world, in life, that's gonna stress us out, that's gonna make us sad. It doesn't help if you don't treat yourself in a nice, kind way. You do it for other people anyway, so you may as well do it for yourself. This is utterly challenging for me because there's so many distractions thrown at us, and it's quite difficult to focus and be in the present moment. We're constantly regretting what we didn't finish off yesterday, anxious about what's going to happen tomorrow, while today just kind of runs away from us. However, each time I notice that my mind is wandered about something that I'm not currently doing, I bring it straight back by taking a deep breath, acknowledging my thoughts, my body, my surrounding. And as you know, mindfulness is being aware of each and every moment. Once you start doing that, you actually start truly living. So be mindful and live in the present moment. This is our only home and we have to take care of it. I honestly believe that everyone has a universal responsibility to think about our planet. So many things that you can do, and information is so readily available that you can get involved in so many different ways. It's reducing your carbon footprint, recycling, more sustainable shopping, reducing your food waste, using more reusable energy. Good wishes is no longer enough. You actually need to be active. There's always something that you can do, and it's so good to be able to know that you are trying to make a difference. Ooh, girl, important. Time is the biggest asset we have, and what makes it the greatest asset is you can't save it, you can't pause it, you can't store it. The time is now. So I started really valuing my time. It changed how I did things that I do. So when it comes to scrolling through Instagram for like an hour for no particular reason, I don't do that anymore, because that's 1 hour that I can use to invest in myself, but learn something, read a book, learn something that would actually impact my life in a positive way. And when you start becoming aware and valuing your time, you actually start doing stuff that you enjoy, that you want to do, and spending time with people that you actually want to be with.
You're funny, girl, you're funny.
Yes, girl, laugh out loud. There's just nothing like laugh. I laugh at every single opportunity that I can, especially with young children. I love making my children laugh over the most silliest stuff, and oh my goodness, the chuckle of children laughing is the best sound in the whole world. It warms my heart, it's such a feel-good factor. So we try and laugh at every single opportunity that we can. I really think that we should make laughter an exercise. Yes, why not? It increases our immune system, it reduces stress, anxiety, and it gives you such a feel-good factor. And to be honest, life is too good not to laugh. I'd love to hear what you guys do to tackle this thing that we call life. Any good strategies that you have, please put them below and share it with us. Thank you so much, my gorgeous friends, and I will catch you soon.